finally, the game is about to begin.
The game is about to begin.
83 World Cup.
83 World
so
Cup.
How prepared are you for the biopic?
It's not a biopic. It is a story about the team. It's an ensemble film. I feel prepared and less anxious than I was when this entire process started. This is the longest I've prepared for any role. Been preparing essentially since January, which makes it
About six months.
I've done 3 weeks, 3.5 weeks, 4 weeks, 6 weeks. 6 months preparing for one character is unique in itself. But then it's a unique film. Playing a living legend poses a unique set of challenges, and your approach to the preparation for that character has to be all the more intensive. And it has been, but at the same time, very rewarding, very fulfilling. Learned a lot about what it means to be an athlete, learned a lot about cricket, and learned a lot about this legendary, iconic cricketer, Kapil Dev. And it's been, the prep phase has been absolutely wonderful. But like you said very rightly, the game begins now.
Okay, that's what you like to say.
Same, just to add to what, may I? Thank you. Just to add to what Ranveer was saying, there's the cricket aspect of the film that everyone is aware of because we've grown up watching these moments and these cricketing videos. But there's a human aspect to this story. And that, as actors, was a challenge for us to pick up those nuances of the living legends that we're playing. And there's so much material out there. There's written text, there are biographies of both Sunil Gavaskar and Kapil Dev. There are interviews online. We've had the benefit of meeting these players. So there's the physical aspect and the psychological aspect. And combining these two, the emotional and the physical, is what's going to make 83 connect with the millennials and cricket lovers.
Okay, Ranveer, you're playing a Kapil Dev role, so you have stayed in his home also for 10 days. So have you taken any tips for the role?
Yeah, of course. I mean, it was a process of taking a lot of tips. Tips on cricket. But like Tahir said very rightly, cricketing is one aspect and then the characterization is another aspect. So it's been a two-pronged prep process in essence. I think what I gained from Kapil Sir himself has been invaluable. There is no other way I would do it. I'm very fortunate, very honored, very privileged that he welcomed me into his home. Was very warm, very welcoming, very forthcoming, and everything that I gained from him during those 10 days is, I think, going to be invaluable in the construction of my performance. Sorry?
The cricket and the film is you're bringing together in a one scene. So how do you see the cricket and the film in one movie?
I think it puts a lot of pressure on us because there are two things in India that everyone has an opinion on. Film, yaar, ye aise ban sakti thi waise, aur dusra hai cricket, wo shot aisa karta tha. Hum dono cheezon ko combine kar rahe hain. So this is great because we're going to get cricket lovers and cinema lovers to come to the theater, but everyone is going to have an opinion, which is pressure in itself. Also, just to pick up on what Ranveer was saying in another interview, ek to mimicry hoti hai. Jab aap cricketer ko utha ke uski mimicry kar lete hain, aur dusra ek representation hota hai. We are very clear, we are artists, we are actors. What you are going to see is Ranveer's version of Kapil Dev, with all due respect to the living legend that he is, and similarly with me and Sunil Gavaskar and all the other players. So as actors, we're going to put in our 110% so that the next generation gets to hear these stories and to relive 83 on the 10th of April, 2020. Subtle plug.
And what a story it is, Tahir.